This week on Cracked Science, how the business world is not immune to cheap parlor tricks. Hey, this is Jonathan Jerry, and you're watching Cracked Science, the show from the McGill Office for Science and Society that separates sense from nonsense on the scientific stage. Business people sometimes have to judge how promising a new science product is to know if they should bankroll it or not. And that requires A, scientific knowledge, and B, critical thinking skills. Now, you may think that experts in the field, like stock traders, for example, will make the right decision more often than someone would by chance alone. But psychologist Daniel Kahneman has argued in his book, Thinking Fast and Slow, that there is general agreement among researchers that nearly all stock pickers, whether they know it or not, and few of them do, are playing a game of chance. The subjective experience of traders is that they are making sensible, educated guesses in a situation of great uncertainty. In highly efficient markets, however, educated guesses are no more accurate than blind guesses. This has been referred to as the illusion of skill. Put simply, it means that you think you can accurately predict things that are unpredictable, and that your success has to do with skill, not luck. If there's nobody around to point this out to you, you can act under the spell for your entire career. Sometimes, however, a prediction is possible because the answer can be known with a little bit of knowledge. But if you lack this knowledge, you may very well make the wrong decision with utter confidence. If you want a beautiful encapsulation of this phenomenon, let's talk about the Dragon's Den episode to end all Dragon's Den episodes. And I realize it's like shooting fish in a barrel if the fish was helping you aim and telling you, come on now, a little more to the left. Dragon's Den is a show in which Canadian entrepreneurs pitch their latest preneur to six venture capitalists, the Dragons, in the hopes of getting significant investments. And on November 23rd, we were treated to the joy and simultaneous bewilderment of the NeuroConnect.
My name is Mark Metis. I'm also from Collingwood, Ontario. I'm a chiropractor, and I've developed a technology to help people's backs get better and stay better. The devices I have developed are with a team of physicists, and they change the atomic structure of the components of these devices to cause the nervous system to respond when you're wearing them. Okay. And as a result, the muscles work better and the joints work better as well.
Yeah. 18 months ago, we actually started using the technology on golfers, and we found that their swing biomechanics and their balance actually improved dramatically. This past year, we attended the PGA Merchandise Show in Orlando. We won the Pinnacle Award, the best new invention in golf.
Let's see it. I can't wait.
Invention in golf.
You have to understand, this is a tall claim, and extraordinary claims like these require extraordinary evidence. So let's see what his machine looks like.
I'm just going to put the clips onto your ankles.
Or to your pant leg, actually.
Yep. And I'm just going to put this clip on you.
Now, if you're going to make me believe that three little clips will improve your golf swing, you're going to have to give an explanation that sounds at least superficially plausible. Something along the lines of, they provide a constant pulse of static electricity that produces micro-adjustments in the muscle's contractions. Surely, the inventor of this gimmick won't say something utterly stupid on national television, that his product works by, let's say, quantum entanglement.
It creates a phenomenon called quantum entanglement.
No. I mean, if he's going to get away with this level of preposterousness, I mean, he might as well throw away the clips and sell them some magic Windex.
It comes in a crystalline spray.
What?
All right.
Whoa. You can spray me and make me more athletic?
Yes. Okay, now that it's on you, you'll have the same reaction as long as the crystals stay there.
Okay.
No, this can't. I don't believe
this. This seems way too good to be true.
Okay, stay with me, because I know that one of the Dragons will intervene and call the man out on his BS, someone who knows that quantum entanglement, a fascinating phenomenon by which some particles seem linked to each other, even over great distances, is not a technology that can be delivered in a spray bottle.
I actually know a lot about quantum entanglement.
Okay.
Oh, thank God.
Like, I've been married twice.
At this point, the Dragons still believe that there's a chance this technology may be a game changer, and they seem to be basing this opinion on the demonstration involving the arm. How else to explain this than the fact that the NeuroConnect works? Now, the arm test is proof that quackery, like the killer in a teen slasher movie, never dies. school children should have to memorize the list of unscientific inventions that have been debunked so that they don't end up like the dragons, rich people in expensive clothes getting ripped off on national television. Instead, skeptics like me have to constantly remind people that we have been here before. I like to think of it as the Jonathan Jerry permanent employment plan. The pushing on the arm to test for strength, that's applied kinesiology, which is nothing more than a parlor trick. Its stated goal is to test how strong a muscle is to infer a medical diagnosis. How it works is super simple. There are two conditions, before and after a particular treatment. And the treatment can be anything. It can even be a pair of scratchy socks steamed with dragon farts. You ask your patient to extend their arm. You press on it away from their body. Their arm looks weak, therefore something is wrong. You ask your patient to put on the dragon fart treated socks. You try again, but this time you press on the arm straight down or even toward the patient himself. The arm looks stronger. Your scratchy socks steamed with dragon farts work. That'll be $60 now. Don't believe me? Let's look at the footage from Dragon's Den. Without the clips, he pushes down and away from her body, which of course is more destabilizing. With the clips, he pushes straight down, which the body can resist much more easily. You can also vary the force you're applying before and after to stack the deck in your favor, because after all, this is how you make a living. Now, you may still not be convinced that I'm right, so we should do a double-blinded test where neither the patient nor the practitioner know if the patient is wearing the NeuroConnect or just ordinary metal clips. It's been done before, with another bit of quackery, the power bracelet, whose magical hologram was claimed to make people stronger. Richard Saunders of the Australian Skeptics conducted a very simple test, and the result was all too predictable.
Next, a series of blind tests. I randomly placed 6 cards in their pockets. Only one, the 5th in line, had the card with the hologram. It was up to Tom to detect who had it.
Well, I'm going to take a real stab at it. I'm going to say, you've got it. So let's have a look in your pockets.
Okay.
Ah, well, there you go.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, I don't have it.
I came here a little bit skeptical, and I'm still a little bit skeptical.
The good news, Power Balance filed for bankruptcy. The bad news, we now have to lather, rinse, and repeat for this neuro-quantum magical clippity-clip crapalooza. And the man who is bringing this clippity bit of nonsense to the dragons has not only dipped a toe into pseudoscience before, he's built an Olympic-sized pool for himself and is swimming in the quantum waters for a living. He has a whole body vibration studio in his practice. He seemingly believes in quantum homeopathy because with the objects he infuses with mystical powers, it appears that less may be more when it comes to subtle energies. Cracking your spine doesn't treat allergies, he says, but he can restore your ability to adapt to allergens. Cracking your child's spine isn't a treatment for infections of any type, he says, but he can restore your kid's ability to fight off an ear infection. Cracking your spine won't treat attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, he says, but dot, dot, dot. He can even grow limbs in his patients. Here's a testimonial from his website. I have been seeing a chiropractor for 10 years. He says I always have a very short leg on the left caused by a pelvic joint restriction, which gives me lower back pain. Since I started wearing a NeuroConnect balance clip, my legs are equal lengths. Soon, we'll see testimonials on his website from the likes of Captain Hook, RoboCop, and Luke Skywalker. Because who needs regenerative medicine and prosthetics when you have quantum mysticism on your side? So, we've got a misappropriation of an interesting physics phenomenon, a debunked parlor trick, and dangerous claims on the inventor's website. Let's see if our wise investors can see through the thinnest of smokescreens. Will they fund this gobbledygook?
Okay. So 5 dragons.
Okay.
For 30% for $100,000, you get the resources of all 5 of us.
Mm-hmm. That sounds good to me. I'm sorry, Manju.
That's okay.
Wow.
There we go.
We're in the health device business, right?
Yes, you're now in the health device business, and you know nothing about health, medicine, parlor tricks, or critical thinking. But you know what? It's business. At the end of the day, it's about selling you something, whether it works or not. Don't take my word for it. I couldn't have made up a better ending than this.
Hey, you guys,
We bought some paper clips and some spray for $100,000. I don't know what we just did there.
I know, but we're going to have a hell of a time marketing it.
My recommendation this week is the book on critical thinking. It should be mandatory reading in every school. It's called Thinking Fast and Slow by Daniel Kahneman, who won the Nobel Prize in Economics. This exposes so much of what we know about how we make decisions and how our brain, in an attempt to go fast, often leads us away from the truth. For example, it goes over why flight instructors in the Air Force thought that yelling at cadets who performed poorly worked better than rewarding them when they did well, in clear opposition to what psychology studies had demonstrated previously. It also talks about the best interview methods, as well as what intuition truly is. It's a fascinating read for anybody who is interested to know how their brain works, and especially for business people who don't want to fall prey to the illusion of skill. If you're watching this video on Dr. Joe's Facebook page, come visit us on YouTube. Our channel has more videos like this one, interviews and content by Dr. Joe himself. Go to YouTube and type in Separating Sense from Nonsense and click the subscribe button. Our office is very active, so find us on whichever social media platform you prefer, Twitter, Facebook, or Instagram. And don't forget our website at mcgill.ca/OSS. You can follow me on Twitter @CrackedScience, and I will see you soon with more Cracked Science.